Hi, thanks for joining me today. I'm going to show you how to make this pillow box, and this is the actual one that we're going to be making. This was the first one I made, and then I decided to add the vanilla hodgepodge hardware, and I also wanted to add the chocolate chip designer series paper. This is another one I made, and this is using a stamp set from the Country Livin' Holiday Collection, and that's going to be available November 1st, and I'll put more details about that on my blog. So I'm going to move these out of the way. Again, this is the one that we're going to be making. I've gone ahead and punched out the pillow box using transparency paper. Some people call it acetate. You can get it at an office supply store. We used to carry them. They were called window sheets, but you can use transparencies now. Okay, so just making sure that my pillow box is going to fold properly. I've put the sticky strip on here, so the first thing I'm going to do is go ahead and close this up. Well, before I peeled that, I should have folded this over. Well, you know what I'll do? I'll fold it backwards so that way I don't get the adhesive on there. It's kind of hard to show you what I'm doing. There's a crease line here, but it's kind of hard to see. There we go. Okay, so now I'm going to fold it back the other way. Okay, so now I'm going to line up this side flap to the end. Hopefully I didn't make that look more difficult than what it is. Okay, so now it's ready to close. Yep, okay. So I've got the end. I'm not going to seal the ends because I want people to be able to get their snack or their little treat out without completely tearing it up. So I'm just going to hold that closed with my finger. And then I'm going to add my chocolate. I have Whoppers in the house, so that's what I'm going to use. I'm going to put 7 in here because they always say to use odd numbers. Now the tricky part, of course, is holding this closed and then getting the ribbon on. It's not the easiest. Okay, it's not hard. It's just I can't hold it all the way up to my face. Come back here. Okay, run away. This little flap isn't wanting to close. There we go. So if you wanted to put a glue dot on here or some sticky strip, you could, just to kind of help you. Okay, I got it. So now I swear I didn't have this much trouble making the other 5 that I've already made, or 6. It's because I'm filming this video. Okay, so I'm going to tie the ribbon the normal way. And then I'm going to slide it to the end, because as you can see, I'm having a hard time holding on to the slippery surface. There we go. Well, and I'm also running my arms around this camera because I wanted you guys to be able to see this up close. Okay, see? So that's done. So now what I'm going to do is slide it down. There we go. Perfect. Okay, get that out of the way. I've gone ahead and stamped this a couple times. This is the Cute and Curly stamp set, and I'm going to use the punch that matches it, or that comes with it. And I'm going to punch one out using this punch, and then I'm going to take the larger oval punch, not the largest, this is like the medium one. If I were going to make this one, I would use the small oval, and it fits pretty good right over top, and I just pop that up with a dimensional. But I'm going to be doing this one, and so I need the oval to be larger so that I can attach it to the hardware. So when you punch this out, it doesn't match. But we're going to be trimming that, okay? So here's my hardware. See how it doesn't fit? But we're going to work on that. So what I'm going to do is put some adhesive on here to get it inside. Okay. And I'm going to leave off the dear friend. Is that what it says on there? Yes, dear friend. I'm leaving that off. Okay, now before I trim this extra, I'm going to go ahead and attach the brads because I don't want to trim it and then not have room to put my brads. Okay, so I've just stuck this on the little chick stand and then I'm going to turn this over and then you're going to need to trim. These brads have little super long prongs. So I've got some wire cutters. Okay. Now, when you're using the wire cutters, just be careful because these little pieces that you're cutting off, they typically go flying. Not sure where that went, but there we go. Okay, so now I'm going to take the scissors and trim off this extra piece of the tag or the oval. And I'm also seeing that I didn't trim the brad as much as I needed to. I don't know if you can see that right there. You don't want that sharp edge to cut somebody or hurt someone. Perfect. Okay, so now we're going to attach this right on here. So what I'm going to do is put a glue dot on the back. The invisible ones. I'm just going to put one right now to save some time, but if I were you, I would probably use three. Hopefully that's straight. Okay, now I've gone ahead and cut my designer paper. This is the Chocolate Designer Series. This is 5.5 by 1.25. Just going to put a little bit of adhesive on the end right here. Wrap it around. And then again, I'm going to put more glue dots on here to attach it. Isn't that cute? And there we have it. And then I just want to play with the ribbon and kind of get it so that it's not covering up the tag. And I'm probably just going to trim it, and that will help. Ah! So there we have it. Okay, if you have any questions, let me know. Thanks a lot. Bye.